poaching is a terrible, terrible vice. Thank you, Hassan Kagure. Educationists have asked the ministry to prioritize industrial training in all primary schools as to equip children with hard life skills. These argue that this will be a solution to the unemployment problem, which they blame on the current system that merely produces office clerks. We have more.
The initial impetus of Skilling Uganda program, which came into play in 2012, was to instill basic industrial skills to satisfy the labor market. Though there is a tangible achievements worth celebrating, educationalists feel primary schools should be the core beneficiaries of the project.
These occupations are being done here. The purpose of the dual curriculum is to equip the learners with skills. These learners, there is what we call long life learning. You start from primary and then you continue in secondary. What is the advantage for the kids? One, they are exposed to the world of work. Because the industry needs people who can do the job. If you go into the hospitality, the baking industry, they can do well.
At primary school, a pupil spends a maximum of 7 years studying for what he or she is to be examined on in just 2 days. But vocational training presents practical life skills such as baking, weaving and carpentry, among others, throughout the child's career.
You know, government developed a thematic curriculum at primary level. The thematic curriculum incorporates these skills. However, majority of our schools are not assessed. There is no recognition of skills. So Mbarara Municipality is one of the pilot. For us as DIT, we are ready. Any school which is ready, you call us and then we assess and certify you.
However, the Minister of Education is yet to roll out the program in all primary schools. For instance, out of 100 schools in Barra City, the program is only at Barra Municipal School, and this disadvantaged other schools.
Advocating for this to other schools because it is vital, because it helps children to be self-reliant in the future, other than relying on government providing jobs and whatever. This development will help children to acquire skills, which skills will help them to employ themselves without bothering the government, bothering the parents and whoever, to provide them with jobs.
But some parents have questioned its significance on grounds that it might shift the attention of learners from passing exams.
Alongside teaching vocational, we have a program of guidance and counseling and career guidance. All these go hand in hand. A well-trained child who is well guided on his or her future career will not drop out of school because of the skill he or she has gained. Instead, he will continue to enrich his or her skills.
We asked the head teacher of Barra Municipal School, where the pilot study of the industrial training is being conducted, how they balance it.
So there is no child who is left out. So if it is time for vocational, all are in vocational. If it is time for class work, all are in class. Only that when we go for vocational, each group goes to its own department.
Though this program, industrialists believe, can serve a purpose once started in all primary schools, it's costly as it requires more funds to procure training equipment.
The building that is yet to be constructed is also funded by the government, and it is estimated to cost 2.4 billion shillings. And we hope in the due course we shall start, because so far we have 400 million at hand, which we shall start with as a startup fund.
Apparently, the emphasis of skilling has been offered to senior four leavers in established institutions overseen by Uganda Business and Technical Examination Board.